the ocean breathes in and out, like the rhythm of the tides, connecting everything from the outer skies to the deepest seas. And at its heart is carbon. Carbon, the building block of life. It fuels nature's solar-powered machinery. From the redwoods to the savanna, to the eelgrass meadows and kelp forests in the sea, and phytoplankton that together, in such abundance, often paint the ocean green. The captured carbon then passes on through all living things, through krill and fish, birds and whales, butterflies and flowers, and you. Most living things hold on to carbon only briefly. Every time we exhale, we let carbon go. When life ends, carbon floats up into the sky or settles down buried in the soil. But in the ocean, things are different. It inhales more than it exhales and sends carbon into the abyss for hundreds and thousands of years. It is the ocean, more than anything else on Earth, that holds the balance. But we humans are releasing ever more carbon, extracting, drilling, and burning ancient carbon stores. And the carbon gathering around the planet has taken on a new identity. No longer just building and powering life, but now disrupting and threatening it too. As we reach for more, taking without thought, discarding without care, the ocean struggles to maintain the balance, to absorb all that carbon. How much is too much? How far is too far? The ocean breathes like the rhythm of the tides, connecting everything. All life depends on this. All life depends on the ocean.